Good morning, good morning. How are you on this wonderful morning? Glasses are off. I am on again. Facebook is having a little, maybe Facebook is cold. The temperature in Toronto is really cold this morning. So I have a funny feeling that Facebook is having a little bit of cold. It maybe needs a little warmth. Somebody should have given it a little tea this morning. But anyway, here we go. Our greeting to self today and all the wonderful things we do is important. It's minus 12 in Toronto, it's freezing. So maybe we'll just have a cozy day, perhaps a fire all day and see how it goes. But anyway, today is one of those days you should stay wrapped up and do something. It's Mental Health Day. And on Mental Health Day, you know, it's a special day devoted to mental health, and we should be conscious of what happens with people during the mental health time, especially during COVID. Many people are having such a hard time with mental health. We know that we've been listening to friends that we know who are having a hard time. It's really not easy. So if you have a moment today, try to remember them by calling someone you know who's having a hard time, by talking to someone who you know that's not really, you know, going well with this time of lockdown and all these things that we're experiencing. So please be kind to somebody today. Serve somebody by saying, hello, how are you doing? You know, whatever happens to you, when you use the hashtag Bell Let's Talk, apparently you send 5 cents towards this mental health program for every call you make. So this is a text, so I think it is. But what we have to remember is that during this time, it's tough for others. So let's look and see what we can do for ourselves this morning also, because we too, even if we feel we are strong and we are wonderful and we can do better and we have all these abilities to do so well, sometimes it's difficult and we don't even know that we are going through it because we're so busy looking at things and not seeing what it is. So no glasses today, let's see how this works. So good morning, and how are you doing today? Greeting to self. Greeting to self is actually, hello. So your greeting to self is, oh, you're so beautiful. How are you doing today? So when you see yourself this morning, what did you say? I went, hi. Hello. It's so wonderful to see you. I've been waiting for you all morning. I've been standing here waiting for you, and I'm so happy. So hello, how are you? It's so nice to see you. Your mantra for today is, I'm attracting special people in my life. This is what our mantra is. We're bringing in special people in our lives. We're attracting them. People that are in cahoots with us, people that blend with us, people that have the same thoughts. And if we happen to bring someone in our life that is not on the same wavelength, we can try to understand where they're coming from and love them and care for them as best as we could. But my morning blessing to you today is our new greeting to self. Hi, hello, here you are. So, greeting to self is important. I started the greeting to self with you guys and it evolved into, hello, how I've been waiting for you, here you are. So it seems that our greeting to self has caused others to raise their bar just a little bit higher. I keep getting calls and people are telling me the greeting to self, they're really enjoying it. As you know, my core thing, my reason, my purpose is to elevate you, pump you, to be the best you, to the best you could possibly be, to inflate you, to perform the best all through the new day, each day. That's my greeting to self to you today, is to make sure that you can always be, every day I come here to pump you up, to make sure that you are the best you could ever be, the best person for the day, the best thing you could create, just working. Good morning. Everybody, good morning, Yoko. Good morning, Hetty. Good morning, is that Corinne? Good morning. Glasses time to put it on so I can see. Good morning, Deborah. To encourage you to take action, to make you free, to make you feel that you are the best, to pump you up, to do and to be the best version of you each and every moment of each day. So I love coming in here. I get pumped, I get excited, I feel great to be here with you every day. When I look and I see you guys here, I feel wonderful. If I don't see you here, I I realize, well, something else has happened. But that doesn't stop me from going pumped, because there's somebody somewhere that's going to get something from you. So the greeting to self is very important. It's really important. We are all asked each and every day to love yourself. As you know, it's mental health day. A lot of people are not happy with who they are. They're not happy with self. They're not happy because perhaps, you know, somebody told them before they weren't great, and they had nothing to offset it with. They had nothing to keep a barrier from the negative greetings they got from people. Sometimes you walk somewhere and you're wearing something and somebody says to you, I don't like what you have on. It doesn't look good on you. Why are you doing this? So people take that to heart because they are going through life, hi Ezra, good morning, trying to please others and trying to see themselves through the eyes of others. But greeting to self in the morning, if you do it with love and care, like as I said, I change it to, here you are. Instead of saying hello, just here you are. It's like a pleasure to see yourself in the morning. If you can do that, you're in the privacy of your home. So you can call yourself and do yourself. Why not use something that makes you laugh? So I change our greeting to self and ask you to greet yourself like you're greeting someone you want to be with, someone you care very much about. Because so often we are told all the things that are not good about us. But if you love somebody, all you see from that person is all the love you can give them. All you want to do is to say, hello, how are you today? So this is important. So you need to greet yourself that way every day, because no one is going to do that for you first thing in the morning. But you must practice it on self. You must love self. I know it's very difficult and it's maybe phony at the beginning, but after a while, it just becomes you. You know, it just becomes the you. And it will help you. It will encourage you, especially in these times where we are so, you know, so many negative things are happening all around us. So when you get up and you say, hello, here you are, you might be exhausted, you might be sleepy, you might still be trying to wipe your eye and get yourself organized, but you get in there and you look at yourself, you know, and you laugh, you're going to laugh. And that is what they say, laughter is the great medicine. They said laughter makes us, we get some other type of hormones that goes through our body when we laugh. They said it takes less wrinkles on your face to laugh than to frown. So laughter has a lot. So you say, hello, here you are. And or you go, here you are, I've been waiting to see you today. And that is to you. I know, take it literally. I've been waiting to see my beautiful face today. I've been waiting to be here today. So anyway, I have been pushing this and I got a call on Monday, but I had already written for the other day. So I thought I'd save it for today. And, you know, this person should always be the first in caring about you, and you are teaching those around you to care and love yourself. So you are the person that's there teaching you, those around you, how to love themselves by you doing the same, which will enable them to care for the others in their life. If you love yourself, if you show patience and gratitude to yourself, this person in the mirror, this person should always be your first person to say hello to. In caring about you, you are teaching others around you to care and love themselves, which will enable them to care for the others in their lives. If you care for you, you will feel empathy. You will feel, you know, for others. You will understand where they're coming from. So this young lady sent me an email. She listens to the morning blessings and sometimes after the broadcast. And she said, when we started listening to them, we were already using and talking about the greeting to self. She knew that. So she said, when she began using them the way I said to use them, at first she felt like, you know, this is not nice. It's a little bit funny, but she's going to persist. And then they began to make her laugh. She said, when we started going, hello, how are you? Here you are. She started laughing, and she said, especially when all she wanted to do was cry, but she continued, and then she began laughing at her greetings to herself. So at first she said it was phony to her, and then she said at that time I was sad, all I wanted to do was really cry. But she said she continued, and then she began laughing at the greeting to self, not because they were funny, but just because they made her laugh. So she come to the point where she was laughing. So she said, the day I said we should greet ourselves like we have been looking for this wonderful, joyful, and awesome friend by saying in the mirror, oh, hello, here you are. And, you know, with a little bit of passion and joy, sprinkled with a large helping of love. She liked the tone. She liked the way it came out. So she stepped right in, and one morning, as she entered the bathroom, she said, oh, here you are. I have been looking for you. At the same time, her husband, who was on his way to the kitchen, stopped and asked her, who are you talking to in the mirror? It sounds like you're meeting a long-lost lover. She said, I began laughing hysterically. She said, she told him, I am greeting me. His reply was, if that makes you happy in the morning, I am all for it. You think it will work for me, he said, and asked her to tell him what she said to herself. I told him it needs passion and joy with a sprinkling of love. So he stepped into the mirror and said out loud, hello, handsome. There you are. We both started laughing and ended up with a kiss and a tight hug. What a way to start the day. I just wanted you to know what you did for me that day. She said, as I said, when I started the morning blessings, I was always in tears. Things were not going the way it should go. But because you said it and I tried it, and when you changed it, I tried it. And by then I had the passion to greet myself. So when my husband heard me and he wanted to know what you're doing, then he said, whatever makes me happy, because he knew what I was going through. So anyway, she said, when he said, hello, handsome, I've been looking for you. She said, they both laughing, ended up in a hug and a kiss. So even if you just have to hug your own self when you say that, but please try to greet yourself, because this young lady enjoyed it. And she said, it was great. She's so thankful for that. So now he steps in the mirror next to her and he goes, yes, I'm handsome, aren't I? And they both laugh. But she said, I don't know where we are going with this, but it has improved our communication, at least in the morning, when I would be so, you know, devastated when I start my day. So be careful with your morning, our greeting to self. It's full of magic. And the more you use it, the more passion and love you will find. The greeting to self is something to lift you up. It's something to protect you from what is not you. It's something to prevent the negative of others to affect you. So this is why I am asking you to honor yourself, love yourself, greet yourself. It's good for your mental and emotional health. It's good. It just makes you laugh. And it's important. It might be silly. And when you think of what you're really seeing in the mirror is a person who just woke up, who's tired, who's bending over the sink, but you look up and you remember, Tessa Marie said, hello, here you are. You must smile, you have to. And when you step out into the world with that type of greeting, who can take it from you? It's not easy, it sounds unusual, but and maybe phony, but with practice, it will become you. And what becomes you is a nice smile every day to greet you. So take care of yourself. Enjoy the day. Start your day with love for you first. When you love you, you're able to love others, even those that you don't always see love coming from. But you will see a tiny speck of love, and you will understand that perhaps that person does not know how to greet self. That person does not have the gift you get every morning to be elevated, to be pumped, to be passionate, to love, to sprinkle love on you. It's not easy. To sprinkle love on self is something that has to be done. No one is going to do it for you. Somebody will love you. Your lover will love you. Your friends and family will love you. But to love you from inside out with all your perfect imperfections only comes from your love to yourself. So what you can do for you every single day is sprinkle a little bit of joy by greeting yourself with love, passion, and just humor. Just say, hello, here you are. I've been waiting for you. So hello, ladies and gentlemen, here you are. I've been waiting for you, sitting here patiently, waiting for you to come. So sending you light and joy on this mental health day. Have fun and love you. Love you first before anybody else can love you, because then you're sure you're worthy of love. And enjoy your day, please, and have fun. So don't forget to like and share the morning blessing. And remember to follow me on my YouTube channel, Tessa Marie Shillingford. So sending you light and joy on this lovely cold winter morning. Send some love to you and let it spread out to the world. Bye. Oh, sorry. I want to see who is here. Glasses time. Ezra, good morning, everybody. Yoko, Hetty, Debbie, Corinne, everybody. What did Corinne say? Good morning. In Toronto, too. Yoko, that's a lot of snow. Yeah, Corinne. Everybody's chatting. I'm so glad you guys are connecting. It's such a wonderful thing. And here comes off those glasses. We don't want them. They're spoiling things. We have to get the new one. March won't be here too soon. So sending you light and joy. And join me tonight. It's our financial night. And we will see what we're going to bring out tonight. 7 p.m. financial advice night. Bye. Take care of yourself, everyone. Bye-bye.